You've probably watched videos telling you that making LED strip too long could lead to serious issues like noticeable variations in brightness along its length, and how this couldn't be easily solved by just increasing the voltage supplying it, including the previous video in this series. However, there is a solution to this problem that just requires a bit of careful planning and maybe a bit of rearrangement of the circuit. We're going to bring together all the information from the previous videos in this series and use this as a worked example to show how to select the correct strip. If you're watching this video on any of our social media accounts and you have no idea what I'm talking about from the previous four videos, then click the link in the description to view it as part of our free training package to help you with your CPD and receive a certificate. And if you're already watching it as part of that free training package, then you're helping to feed my family, so thank you. Let's take a look at our example. I want to install some strip to the underside of this worktop just to bring a bit of life to the kitchen. Because it incorporates a breakfast bar, it's a bit longer than you might think. In fact, the total length is just over 8 meters. Now I want to install some strip that will do it all. White light to help with cleaning the floor and drawer fronts, but also some color changing options for when it's, you know, party time. So I need a RGBW strip, but will it be SMD or COB? Well, it's not on display as it'll be hidden underneath the lip of the worktop. So I'm not worried about spotting or being able to see the individual LEDs. I could use COB, but I want to take the strip around the corners of the worktop quite tightly. And I can use these clever little L bends for that, whereas COB isn't as friendly for flat 90 degree bends. So on balance, I'm happy to go with an SMD strip for this application. I'm tempted to go with IP67 because it passes in front of this sink and I'm a bit worried about any spillage from the washing up dripping onto it, but I've had a little play with some water dripping off and it tends to just run off the front rather than seep back towards where the strip will be. The other slight issue is that the IP67 strip tends to be a bit thicker and I'm worried the drawers might bosh into it when I open them, so I'm going to go with IP20 with its lower profile. If I'm really worried, I could just run a tiny bead of clear silicone under the section where the sink is. The water will hit this and then drop off before it gets to the strip. Now we need to select the correct driver as we learnt in video 3. The RGBW SMD strip has a power rating of 14 watts per meter. This will obviously vary depending on what output setting it's on, but we need to allow for it. So we've got 8.2 meters of strip to power. 14 watts per meter multiplied by 8.2 gives us 114.8 watts of power. And so we'll need to select a driver that can provide that much power. Again, don't be tempted by the fact that it's only just over 100 watts we need to go to the next one up, which for a 12 volt strip is this 180 watt option here. This is the largest 12 volt driver that Robus make. If we needed more power than this, we'd need to either think about a 24 volt strip and driver, as they can deliver a bit more power up to 320 watts, or split the strip into different sections, which brings us nicely onto our next point. The challenge we have with RGBW is that it uses more power than a single color LED, and because of that, more current needs to flow through the strip. This increases the volt drop along the strip, and that means that I can't install a single length of this more than 5 meters, but I need just over 8 meters. So what's the solution? Well, we've got a tendency to view LED strip as being a single long length that gets fed from one end, and that's certainly the simplest way to install it. But it doesn't have to be. You can run LED strips in parallel out of the power supply. By connecting the ends of two strips into the power supply, you can see that they're both getting 12 volts supplied to them because they're in parallel with each other. And just because they're wired in parallel doesn't mean they physically need running in parallel with each other. And that's exactly what we're going to achieve here. If we locate the power supply and control box roughly in the center of the LED strip run and then take one of the strips out this way and the other one out in the opposite direction, we could get a 5 meter length going this way and a 5 meter length going the other way, giving us a 10 meter run in total. And that's how we can double the length of LED strip from a single power supply, and also how we can get some seriously awesome effects for this kitchen using RGBW LED strip. Clever stuff. So that brings us to the end of this series on LED strip. If you're watching on our training platform, then answer the multiple choice questions that follow and you'll receive your certificate for your CPD records. If you're watching on one of our social media channels, then click the link to move over to the free training package and get yourself a certificate, or click this video right here to see some more awesome products from Robus. All that remains in this series of videos is to say thank you very much for watching.